Have you ever wondered what if the sack of Rome in 410 never would have happened? Well, today we're gonna talk about the people who lies behind that sack, the Goths. We're gonna talk about where they came from and what they did, and the Visigothic kingdom. So, the Goths came from southern Sweden and the island of Gotland. It's in the name, right? Right? They probably thought, I'm tired of this land, aren't you? Yeah. I've heard about a large empire to the south. We should wreck that, yes. Probably something like that. Anyway, they load onto their boats and sail down to the Vistlas River and settled near the river. And eventually came to the Black Sea and took over the island of Crimea. And it's here around the groups split and became the Viso and Ostrogoths. I'm gonna focus on the Visogoths, and in another part I'll focus on the Ostrogoths. So, what forced the Visigoths to move into the Roman Empire? As usual, the Huns! Sounds like fun on a Hun. This is so bad. So, the Huns conquered the Ostrogothic kingdom. The first one, that is. The Visigoths thought, I don't want to be killed, so what am I going to do? I know, settle in the land of the Roman Empire. That was a mixed decision. So, as expected, the Romans treated them bad. Really bad. So, they revolted and it went pretty good until Theodosius the Great came and beat them in battle and got them to calm down. And even made an alliance with an old chieftain that was a former enemy. Very weird. So, the Goths worked as a buffer state as long as Theodosius lived. In 395, Theodosius died and the Goths decided to elect a new leader. Alaric the First. When Alaric took power, the alliance with the Romans went down. The Romans started treating his people like shit. He got some allies and tried to take Macedon to get a great deal, but the Romans didn't really listen. So he tried to take Constantinople. That didn't go too well, and he had to buy his way out. Then he went on a burning spree in Greece, he burned a lot of cities, even Athens. Then he went back to Italy and just got defeated 2 times by a Roman general named Stilicho. He is important. And after that, a bunch of barbarians, every person that is not Roman, migrate to Gaul, and Stilicho was needed to negotiate a peace because he was needing Gaul, but the emperor didn't agree on that. So he, Alaric, besieged Rome, 410, the siege of Rome. Well, the siege was kind of successful. They plundered Rome, but the siege did minimal damage. It wasn't so bad, they destroyed the garrison, but the civilian population was mostly fine. Then, they wanted to form their kingdom in Africa and Sicily. But then, Alaric died in the same year that he sacked Rome. Must have been a big stress. That don't make sense. So, his brother-in-law, Atulf, took over. So, in 403, the emperor gave Alaric ownership of Spain and Gaul. But they need to take over cities, because they didn't support the Goths. So, they marched to the southern Gaul and founded the Visigothic kingdom with the capital of Toulouse. Then, in 418, Theodoric I took over. Not Theodoric the Great of the Ostrogoths, Theodoric I of the Visigoths. He died in battle of the Catalonian fields, where Huns, Ostrogoths fought Romans and Visigoths. The Ostrogoths was a subject of the Huns. The Huns kind of lost the battle. We don't actually know who won the battle. The Huns took a bunch of casualties and it stopped their advance into Europe. But the great general Theodoric I of the Visigoths died. But this video is about the Visigoths and not the Huns. So Theodoric's son, Euric, was good. He conquered most of Spain, actually. Alaric II lost the battle against the Frankish king, so the Gothic advance north stopped. It took 8 years to conquer the north. Then, in 711, the Arab of Tariq ibn Ziyad conquered the Visigothic kingdom, and they failed the test of time. So, to sum it all up, so, yeah, in the end, the Visigoths did a bunch of things. They sacked Rome, they set up a kingdom, then the thought that some Swedes were a big part to the death of the Roman Empire and set up a kingdom in Spain is kind of unbelievable nowadays. But this was IVTM, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.